Well, I was, as a visual artist, I always, in my work, look at layers and connections between various generations. And when I moved in Corandola in 2008, I was aware of the national school and the nursing home being adjacent to each other and just being separated by a wall. And I was aware as well that there was more than a wall separating them. It was a big gap. So basically, I came up with an idea. I researched a lot about intergenerational work and liaise with the principal and the manager of the nursing home, and basically started a project, and that's basically how it started 4 years ago. Now we have a yearly partnership. We basically organize 2-3 projects per year. Some are just one session, some are about 8 weeks. It all depends, but yeah, it's growing in strength.
What do you need to do? You need to be very organized.
Very good.
First of all, I mean, you have to make contact. Okay, so you have to make sure that the people that you approach obviously fit within the demographic requirement, i.e. all the people and children. So working with retirement groups and schools, within library, day centers, nursing homes, I mean, basically you have to be aware, okay, of this. You have to be extremely clear with your group what you're going to do, how much it's going to cost, what's the timing, how much time do you have to plan, when you're going to do it, who. Basically, you have to be extremely clear, okay? You have to be able to liaise with people and be enthusiastic and carry that enthusiasm to other people. Because, I mean, the first time I organized a project, people didn't know me. I'm not even from Ireland. So, it's not. I'm not saying it was barriers. It was in a little bit, and people were not used to this kind of project, so I had to carry that enthusiasm and say, this is going to work, this is fantastic. So you have to have that energy constantly. It's always have to be there, okay? And you have to be aware of how convenient it's going to be for the people to actually participate. You're not going to have young children after 8. You have to be aware of the older people's mealtime, for example, if you go into the nursing homes. Okay, what is it? So is it during school hours? You want to do it outside school hours? You have to be basically aware of all of this. Secondly, it's how are you going to develop your session? Is it going to be one hour, or is it going to be 8 sessions of an hour? My advice would be never go over an hour, because attention span, and it's better to actually short and sweet. Not less than an hour, but I would say an hour and 15 minutes is perfect, because people arrive, people will have developed relationships, so basically they would, hello, how are you? You know, things like that. You have to leave some time before you actually start. You have to obviously to be very prepared, always prepare. Okay, always be aware what you need, the scissors that you're going to use, have children going to be able to use that, pencil, you know, I mean, details, always pay attention to a lot of details, and everything has to be laid out before the session. You know, you arrive half an hour in advance and you make sure that everything is there, and you know, if you're using, for example, a day center, bring, I don't know, newspaper if you're going to work with paint. You know, I mean, you always have to be very, very, very careful of what you're going to bring with you. Consent form, if, for example, you're working with children, you have to be aware that you have to ask the parents to fill a photograph consent form, because you can't use pictures of children, obviously, without their consent. And you have to also, I mean, that's against respect to all the people, you have to ask them, are you okay to basically your picture being taken? You know, it's a question of respect. Don't take anybody for granted. And that's the thing, don't take, because they're all the people. You know what I mean? That, you know, they're not going to be like the children. It's the same idea, you know? You have to have that respect. And you have to be always very clear on what you're going to do on the sessions. Because sometimes you get a bit carried away. Like, for example, the session we had two weeks ago, everybody was very happy to be in each other's company, which was fantastic. But be clear, okay, there's something needs to be to achieve as well. So it's an healthy balance of the fun and the organization.